is Fiona Watt, and I'm the director of the Centre for Stem Cells and Regenerative Medicine at King's College London. The centre represents a major investment by the college in this very exciting and potentially very useful area of research. Stem cells are cells which have the ability to make more cells and also produce other cells that undergo a process of maturation, which we describe as differentiation. And by that I mean really the kind of cells that you need for the normal function of your tissues. That might include the red blood cells that carry oxygen around your body. It might include the cells that make the hairs on your head. So if you take cells from an adult tissue and reprogram them to make them pluripotent or have embryonic characteristics, that's called making iPS cells. The discovery of iPS cells by Shinya Yamanaka back in 2006 led to him being awarded the Nobel Prize in 2012. And the reason that people are so excited about his discovery of iPS cells is that they have tremendous potential to be used to improve human health. So iPS cells can be used in a number of different ways. One is to take cells from patients who have particular diseases and use those to study disease mechanisms. Why is it that a cell from somebody who has a disease like autism or diabetes, why do those cells behave differently from cells from somebody who is healthy? Following on from that, they also have the potential to be used for drug discovery, to find drugs that are effective in treating disease. And then, of course, there is the hope that iPS cells might one day be used for what's called personalized medicine. That if you could make iPS cells from somebody who has a disease, correct them or expand them in the lab, and potentially transplant them back into the patient, that would be potentially a very exciting new treatment.
So we can grow the different populations of stem cells in different culture dishes, etc. And to expand them, to allow us to manipulate them, we can grow them in tissue culture flasks. And here I'm just growing primary human stem cells that we isolate from patients in different conditions, which allows us to study their responses to different nutrients, different factors, growth signals. We can also modulate gene transcription to study how that affects the behavior of these stem cells.
So in November 2012, the Wellcome Trust and the Medical Research Council announced that they were investing £12.75 million in a project which we call HPSI. HPSI stands for Human Induced Pluripotent Stem Cell Initiative. Our job is to develop assays of cell behavior. We're taking two different approaches to that. One is to take what we call a high throughput approach, where we feed thousands of cells into a machine which looks a bit like a freezer, but in fact it's a very sophisticated microscope with a computer attached. And this will make measurements on how cells behave in response to different stimuli. Another component of what we have set up is what we like to call the stem cell hotel. And the idea there is that we take more time to analyze in detail the behavior of cells. We don't have the expertise to do that by ourselves, but at King's we're very fortunate to have a wonderful network of clinical collaborators from all of the different hospitals that form part of King's Health Partners. And our intention is to invite collaborators from the different hospitals in to work with us in the hotel for short or long periods of time to hone in on disease mechanisms in more detail. The Centre for Stem Cells and Regenerative Medicine can be seen as a hub or a nucleus for a large amount of stem cell related activity that is taking place in the different campuses of King's College London. There are three things which I believe make it a very special environment. One is academic excellence. We have fantastic scientists from all over the world working here with different expertise. Secondly, there's been a major investment in core facilities, so that a young scientist joining our centre is really only limited by their imagination when it comes to carrying out research. All of the facilities that are required and the underpinning expertise is here. And thirdly, and I believe most importantly, is the unique culture of collaboration. People who have very different backgrounds coming together to work jointly on projects, which really will move stem cell research forward into the clinic.